Hi YouTube, Michigan Snow Pony Renee. And I know some people were curious about what my carrot harvest was going to be this year with all my plants going to flower, or many of them. And I'm curious too. Usually I can wait till like the very end of season, which is now, before I pull my carrots, and that's usually what I do because I'm so busy canning and preserving everything else from the garden that I kind of leave the carrots in the ground. And I usually do that with the potatoes too, but this year we wanted to get the wheat started, so we pulled the potatoes early. But those two plants usually just wait for me. This year, I don't think the carrots did, so I'm not real optimistic about my carrot harvest. And generally, I do not thin my carrots, but this year, that might bite me in the butt. This has been a different year. I mean, between the lilacs blooming and the carrots blooming, it's just been different. So we'll see what I get, and I'll share it with you and go from there. Now, am I going to be saving some seed from these carrots? Well, I thought about that. And what I decided was, no, I don't want to save seed because, well, I'm kind of curious, actually. I thought I didn't want to save seed because I don't want carrots that are going to bloom the first year. I want the biennial carrots because when they bloom, and we'll pull this one so you can see, the carrot usually is very small or non-existent, or it's big and woody, and so it's not good for eating. Do I really want to grow carrots that are going to bloom the first year, and so I don't get carrots? There's that thought. Or I thought, well, maybe this is just a fluke, and this doesn't mean that they are going to be prone to bloom the first year. I don't know. It might be worth saving some seed so I can experiment, plant some of these next year in a small plot, and just see what they do, to see if it's a genetic mutation or if it's just a fluky year, you know, 2020. I don't know. I'll decide about that as I pull them. But you can see I've got a few here and there that look like first year carrots, and then the other ones. So I'm just going to go through and pull them. We'll see what I get. Okay, let's just get some of these woody ones out. See, that's a big old woody carrot. Don't want that. Next to it, we have a little short one. We'll save that one. And these are short. Usually I get nice long carrots. I had a feeling. I had a feeling this year was just going to be different. Oh, something ate that one. Yeah. Look at these carrots. These are not my normal, typical carrots. If you look at that other video I made, it's usually what happens. I get spoiled. But this year, and these are the same type of carrots that I've always grown. They're either the Nantes or the, you know, Scarlet Nantes, N-A-N-T-E-S, or there's another kind, I can't think of it. But, and I think leaving them, oh my goodness, oh, that's funny. Look at that one. Oh my goodness. That's funny. See what happens when you don't thin your carrots? I'm going to use that though. I can chop that up. Oh, there's one up here. Usually they don't keep growing, but these kind of did. Interesting. Yeah, they all kind of did the same thing this year. Instead of letting me get away with it, they're looking like carrots that weren't thinned. But even this little plant did it. Wow, that's wild. I don't know what to think. Some of you probably don't know the answer. But I don't, because I've never had this. Oh, look it. What? And sometimes your carrots won't go down in the ground if you don't have soft ground. You know, if you're on clay. We are on sandy soil. They should have had no problem going down. For whatever reason. Oh my gosh. They did not. All right, that one's just kind of obscene. Interesting harvest this year, all the way around, guys. All right, I'm going to just continue on with these oddly shaped carrots. Now, this one's got flowers. Oh, my gosh. And I'll show you what I get when it's all done. Oh, boy. Oh, let's just pull this one out. I'm curious. Yeah, see, that's usually what you get. You don't get too much of a carrot when it decides to make flowers. Usually the second year. Huh. Oh well. All right, I'm just going to go down the row, and I'll bring you back when I'm done and show you the results. Okay, fat and squat seems to be the theme this year. This one is so fat, and it's just one carrot. I don't know what to think of this year. I really don't. All right, on we go. Finally, I'm getting to a section like I normally get, and that's these right here. Hopefully, these will be my salvageable normal carrots, because this is what usually happens. I just get regular carrots. I spoke too soon. There's another one. I started pulling these and thought, oh, there's my normal carrots. But even these, they're just fat around. Now that's one plant. That's gonna go to the pigs. But what's with this fatness? I don't get it. There's a normal carrot. That one has tumors. Alright, those two were too close together and it split. See? Those are pig carrots. They'll be thrilled. See what that did? See? Don't listen to me. You should thin your carrots. Usually it doesn't bite me in the butt, but this year it did. Okay. Carrying on. See how they're just crowded in there. And there's another beastie. Gosh, maybe I got... Ooh. There's some more. I can salvage these. I mean, I will get some carrots to can, but... even the ones... They're... I'm puzzled. Just puzzled. Okay. Well, these are Halloween carrots. There's a spider. I found more... Now I have a carrot spider. There's its body. There's its head, see its legs. Okay. Maybe it doesn't have eight, but I found more animals in my garden this year with the vegetables. Ah, my little space aliens. Oh, this is a hand. You gotta have fun when you're gardening, guys. I can't be all serious. Okay. Well, all right, I said I was gonna come back. I'm really gonna do it this time when I'm all done. Okay, there is the pig share. The other one's sleeping in the hutch, and the other two are up there at the feeder. This one's enjoying the fruits of the garden. And then here is what I got. That I decided I could save and salvage. And, you know, I cut these up and I'll make medallions out of them. And no one will know that I had freakish carrots this year. But I can't get over the circumference and how they kept growing. I mean, they kept growing. Usually they don't. Usually they just kind of reach a point and they stay there until I get to them. This year, they just kept going and going and going. I mean, they were ridiculously large. Oh, I don't think I want that one. That one's split. I mean, and this one on the end. Stay Puft Marshmallow Man, or Carrot Man, I don't know. But the big, huge carrot next to my hand. Oh well. So, there you go. There's my carrots for the year. Another thing I did while I was back here is I put a little short row of garlic in next to the wheat. And I had elephant garlic, because that's what the store had. I've never grown garlic before, but I had 10 cloves, so I just put it right here, and you can see the wheat's still growing. See what it looks like next spring. That will be the tell, but we'll see how I do with the garlic. Like I said, never grown it, but we eat a lot of garlic, so I thought, okay, I'm going to try it, and I'm still getting quite a few little side shoots. Of course, they're smaller this time of year, but of the broccoli. And I'm going to be back here picking that. It actually does better once the weather cools off. Even though we've had a frost, it's still going. And the nice thing about this time of year is those little butterflies are dead. And the honeybees are finding the flowers. They're still out and about. don't know if you can see him. So I kind of leave it up for them too. Yeah, they're all over in here. It's cool as it is today. So I gotta pick my broccoli, and then I'm pretty much done for the garden. I'm thankful that I do have carrots planted in the greenhouse for fresh eating this winter. Hopefully that will pan out. And then I'll just can up all these, and no one will know they were Franken carrots. Except you folks. Okay, till next time, guys.